You must visit the expo center because it has a very ethnic kind of design. The crush hall is also very appealing. It doesn't look like if you would walk into the crush hall or you would walk into the arcade, the first thought that would come to you was, wow, is this an expo center? Yes, it is an expo center with a difference.
So any message you'd like to give to our audience, the organizers across the globe, and you'd like to say something to them?
Yeah, I'd like all the exhibition organizers to at least choose once the World Trade Center and experience the wow effect of World Trade Center. You will know the services given by World Trade Center all over the world are excellent. And I would like to add that we have been given the certificate by the World Trade Center Association, the excellent certificate for all the facilities and services provided by the World Trade Center Mumbai.
So today we are sitting with well-known figure in the Indian MICE industry. She's worked with the industry associations. She's given 28 years of her life working for the industry associations. We're sitting with none other than Ms. Rupa Naik, Senior Director of World Trade Center. Now the World Trade Center was established in 1970 in Mumbai. We'll talk to the lady herself. Ma'am, can you please introduce us to yourself for our subscribers?
World Trade Center Mumbai is called as the MVIRDC World Trade Center Mumbai. MVIRDC stands for Visveshwaraya. M Visveshwaraya Research and Industrial Center. So the idea of the World Trade Center came up in the year 1960s perhaps, and from there it took off, and that was a time when Mumbai was buzzing as a commercial center, commercial city of India. So they decided, why not have the World Trade Center itself in Mumbai? So that's how in the year 1970 World Trade Center came up. We began with the arcade, which houses the expo center. So the idea of providing banqueting facilities, conference rooms, workshops, spaces, arbitration areas. So all this came up in that year. Can you imagine how long ago that was?
1970.
Yes.
Oh my God.
So if you look at that, I think that they had the foresight to imagine that exhibitions, arbitrations, conferences, MICE industry is going to grow fast. And it did grow. So today we are located in the most vibrant part of Mumbai and probably the most elite part of the city. We have the Arabian Sea from every angle of World Trade Center. So World Trade Center is also a member of the World Trade Center Association, New York. So there are about 326 World Trade Centers in over 90 countries. And every World Trade Center strives, or its goal is to make sure that they provide trade infrastructure. So you can have a small desk space, or you can have an office of 30,000 square foot.
Okay.
I mean, 30,000 is just an abstract figure I gave you, but you can have big office spaces. You can start as a small, if you are a startup, you can get a small desk space also in this World Trade Center. So world over, World Trade Centers are like mini cities, mini commercial cities. They also have hotels, they have malls, they have residential complexes. But we do have here a shopping center which has different state emporiums. So now with the emerging technologies and Amazon and all these different platforms through which you can shop, it's very difficult for all these showrooms to be here. But we still have, we have Kashmir, we have handicraft showroom, we have UP, we have Madhya Pradesh, we have Maharashtra, we have Karnataka. We have some of these showrooms still here and they're all doing well. Yeah.
So I would like to understand how World Trade Center is promoting the events industry. He is having some kind of a infrastructure to hold good conferences, exhibitions, meetings at this venue. Do you have some support mechanism, and if so, ma'am, can you tell me what kind of infrastructure do you have and what kind of facilities can organizers get from your venue?
So the exhibition hall, that's the expo center, it's about 25,000 square foot, but if you take the crush hall and if you take the other halls which are adjacent to it, then we can always very safely say you can get at least about 35,000 to 40,000 square foot area. You can even build extra if you want. You can even take the courtyard. As far as the infrastructure facilities go, we give you almost every support that you need to make sure that your exhibition gets all the backup that it needs, right from the stall contractors to Wi-Fi to catering, any furniture that you need, screens, LED screens, photography, anything that you need, we have all the vendors with us.
Oh, wow.
We provide you almost everything at the most competitive prices.
Okay.
We also allow most of the exhibitions to run beyond the normal time, which is normally up to 6:30, and
yes,
we allow them to even go on till 8 o'clock.
Okay.
Most of the exhibitions that are held here, some of them are really, really, very interesting. We have fashion design, we have scat, we have the Thailand show. Thailand show is really very, very popular. Now they actually have a show happening in BKC, and they also have a show happening right here, because this market is the market which is has the purchasing power parity. They are rich people living, the residentials here are very rich.
Yes, and I think even as we talk now, we have an exhibition running here, like a stamp exhibition is going on.
Yes.
This is a kind of niche kind of exhibition.
This is a very different, we also have something, the coin exhibition happening.
Okay.
We have the stamp exhibition happening, which are out of the, you know, not the state of the art kind of exhibitions, but something out of the box kind of thinking.
Mm-hmm.
We recently had called something called the Art Rival, which is artisans which were doing different kinds of paintings and different kinds of art related crafts, which were exhibited here, and it was a 3-day exhibition. It was extremely well received by the people around here. We also have the Upper Crust, which is a food show where different countries participate, and people like over here love to come and taste food because they love to go to restaurants, and Cuff Parade has very few restaurants. We also have a very good restaurant right here within our complex.
In-house.
Yes. We have a restaurant here. We have all kinds of facilities that any exhibitor would need. Parking. Today, parking is a big challenge in this city. I'm sure you know about it.
Absolutely.
Parking is not possible. So we have a huge parking area. We have parking space which can put up easily 400 to 500 cars.
Nice. That's free of cost?
During exhibitions, to the exhibitors, we give it free.
Very nice.
People, visitors, we normally give it free because that is how we bring our footfalls.
Yes.
I'd like to also add that the escalator here was the first escalator of the city.
Okay.
So there were a lot of people who used to come in those days to just see the escalator here at that time.
Okay. That's one of the charming points about this.
Yes.
You
must visit the Expo Center because it has a very ethnic kind of design. The Crush Hall is also very appealing. It doesn't look like, if you would walk into the Crush Hall or you would walk into the arcade, the first thought that would come to you was, wow, is this an expo center? Yes, it is an expo center with a difference.
Are you also open to partnerships with organizers, like to support them? Can you also do some kind of a joint ventures? You can have them on
board. Of course, we are open to explore any such possibilities, but we are more happy providing it as a venue because we are venue providers.
As a venue provider.
But we would be happy to discuss if there is any such possibility.
Mm-hmm. And I also come to know that, you know, the security is also very sound,
yes,
and very professional as compared to other venues.
We have 24/7 security here. We have the fire department.
Is it CCTV monitored?
Everything is CCTV monitored. The entire hall, you can't lose anything. If you've lost anything, we can retrieve it for you within half an hour to 1 hour because our CCTVs are on all the time, and they are there are two or three staff members who keep watching the CCTV every second to see if there is something going wrong within the Expo Center. We also have a very good fire department here. So in case of any small mishap also, they are there on the house all the time, the engineering department, the housekeeping department, they're all there during the exhibitions.
In fact, while I was coming upstairs to meet Rupa ma'am, I also witnessed a fire drill which was going on. So is it a routine affair here?
Yes, you know, as per the regulations of the government, we are supposed to have fire drills.
Okay.
And these fire drills happen almost 3 times a year.
Okay. And ma'am, it has also been observed that internationally, every good infrastructure, MICE infrastructure, has some kind of a hotel space in the vicinity.
Yes.
Can you throw some light upon what kind of arrangements are there in and around this place?
So there are 3 to 4 very good hotels here. We have the Taj, which is the Taj President, which is 3-minute walk from here.
Oh, nice.
And we have special rates also with them. Then there is the Taj Palace, Taj Intercontinental, and we have the Trident, the Oberoi. And also there are a lot of budget hotels.
Okay. Maybe for the visitors, exhibitors.
Or, yeah, those who are exhibitors and they would like to have a budget hotel. Mm-hmm. Then there are many such budget hotels available here. There's the Ambassador, there's Farias. There are many, many hotels around. And most of these hotels, what's the beauty of this place is that walking in this area is a pleasure.
Mm-hmm.
It's not as crowded as other areas.
Yes, I think because the sea is just...
The sea is right next to you.
Yeah.
You have the sea, you have good footpaths, and people around here love walking.
And as you said, ma'am, you have a shopping complex right next door. So, which is again one of the very strong, attractions for international exhibitors and for organizers as well, because they want some rejuvenation.
Right. So we have shopping just a very few stores here. We have Raymond's, we have Birla, Aditya Birla Group's shirtings and suitings, and we have a couple of handicrafts, and we have jewelry. But we also have the Maker Arcade, which is a huge shopping center right next to us. So if people want to go and shop for something else, they can always go there.
Probably there's a souvenir showroom.
There's a souvenir showroom, but
souvenir, yeah.
Yes, there is a souvenir showroom. There are Maharashtra showroom is very nice.
Okay.
Because a whole lot of handicrafts of the state are exhibited there.
Mm-hmm.
You get from precious stones to pearls to wooden beads. You get silks, leather. A lot of stuff at the Maharashtra show.
On that note, ma'am, thank you for talking to Exhibition Showcase.
Thank you, Doctor. Thank you so much. And I wish you all the very best.
Thank you.